What up, what up, what up, jabronis? I'm Wizkid, and today we are continuing down the shameful path that is my gacha game journey by taking a look at one of my favorite releases from this year, Counterside. We're going to be taking a look at some of the gameplay, we're going to take a look at the waifus and husbandos I've charmed along the way, before finally ending with some pulls on the latest banner and just talking about my thoughts on the game. So with that, let's go already! Let's begin by just appreciating and taking a look at my beautiful, well-designed home screen. Jesus, what the hell was I on? Anyways, let's load up a battle so I can talk a bit about the combat. In most cases, you're going to begin by adding squads to the field. A squad in this game consists of a maximum of 8 characters, as well as a ship, and as well as a ship operator. For example, Team Waifu, yes that includes Kyle, is the first squad I'm going to deploy with the Lake Superior ship. You add them to the field, and then you start the operation. Once the operation is started, you can move your little squads around the map, strategy RPG style. Different ships and ship types move differently, with some being able to move multiple spaces and others only being able to move one. Once a ship encounters another ship though, that is when the true combat begins. The way that combat works in this game reminds me a little bit of like auto chess games. If you've played something like Clash Royale, then the premise is pretty much the same. You deploy units on the screen using a resource that automatically replenishes. Each character fits a different role. There's defenders who soak damage and act as tanks. There's rangers who fight from the back. Strikers are like the swordsman melee types that fight right up front. And then you've got snipers who just, you know, they're chilling on the way back like they always do. The characters attack and they do the skills on their own, even when you control things manually, which right now everything's in auto. The only part that you really control, even in manual play, is when you place the units and where you place them, and when to use their ults too. For the most part, you're just gonna auto your way through most of the PvE content and save manual for PvP. Speaking of PvP, it's definitely one of the main sources of content in this game. There's two different PvP modes. Strategy Battle is your regular auto battle PvP mode where units are basically deployed in the order that you set them up in. You can do 6 of those a day and they're super easy to get through. The true PvP in this game though is Ranked Battle. This is a real-time player versus player mode where you control fights the same way you would in PvE. You deploy units to try and destroy the other player's ship. In this mode, you kind of have to think a lot about when to deploy your units, what kind of synergy exists within your units, and what type of gear you're rocking to support the theme of that team. There's a lot of experimentation happening, and people get to be really creative. My team's theme, for example, is I am a filthy f***ing whale who has all the awakened units, and so you're probably dead. I'm going to talk more about awakened units later, but the basic premise is that they're just filthy powerful, man. Usually way, way, way more powerful than the regular SSR units. Anyways, let's jump into a match and embarrass ourselves. We're up against Senya Miku. Let's see how this goes. All right, so we are now starting the PvP match. We definitely don't want to auto. And it has been a while since I've done this, so forgive me, counter side stands, because shit's about to look real ugly. Oh no. Okay, so I think that's the new unit, and I am afraid for my life. I think I kill her here. Okay, no, I do damage to her. I do this. So I just use the ship skill. Hopefully that does something. I don't know what I'm doing. I play waifu Kyle Wong. Okay, I think this works. Hopefully this works. Okay, I'm throwing. I want to play Gayun. I have banned units. This isn't good. This is not good. Die? That kills you? You die? And I do this? Please. Oh no 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 no. You save me. Basket there. I got a emote on them. Emote to win. emote to win. Play the sniper. Oh God, oh God. Okay, so I lost. And that's only because I don't have the latest unit. You know, it's fine. All right, I lost. So with that, let's take a look at my units and see what else we got cooking, huh? So I've sorted to only show SSRs for the sake of the video. And as you can see, there's still a crap ton of people left. The rates are pretty generous in this game, so you're probably going to have a lot of SSRs yourself. As I scroll down, you're going to see a few with skins, a few without skins. I'm going to pop into a few of them to show you probably one of the main reasons people really like this game. I haven't really built everybody that I want to build, looking at you, Sigma, but I've got a decent number of level 100s to play around with. Let's take a look at some of my favorites. In this game, every character has a live 2D model without exception. And as you can see, the quality of the models are very nice. This is Gayun, and she's probably one of my favorite characters in the game. And as you can see, I'm rocking the Valentine skin that weirdly came out in the summer. Now we're going to take a look at Yuna, who I think was the awakened unit to come out like 2 or 3 banners ago. I just love her Phoenix, man. Something to note is that, you know, I think the devs in this game be thirsty, man. I think they be real thirsty. I mean, I don't even use Karen Wong that much, but holy moly, man. If you play games like Azur Lane, you're probably used to this level of fan service. To me, yeah, this, oh my God, this is ridiculous. Listen, I'm not going to lie and say that I don't like the fan service. I really, you know, I like it enough, but I mostly appreciate the quality of these skins. You can see too that their chibi models are modified, and sometimes they even modify the ult animation, which is, you know, it's a nice detail. It's usually just a smidge, but oh, and one thing I wanted to briefly mention in this game is that a really nice part about this game is that you only really need to pull the character once to be able to max them. Dupes really aren't that helpful because you can pretty much grind all the currency that you need to level them up. To break them past 100, you're just going to need these special items called fusion cores, but you'll get enough of them just by playing the game to get a few 110s in your belt. Enough of the waifus though, Terminator being the best waifu. Let's go and see if I can pull the latest one. This is the recruit screen, and here you're going to see a bunch of different options for summoning. Let me talk a bit about the differences between each of these. In the beginning, we only had normal recruitment, which just could be considered the regular SSR characters. The chance to pull these are 3.5%, and the employment contracts that you use to get them, these blue books, are probably the most easily obtainable kind of summoning currency that you get. Moving on to classified recruitment, these are the units that we all call awakened units. The rates are pretty much the same, 3.5%, but the currency that you need to get them is way harder to get and accrues at a much, much, much slower pace. If you've played something like Epic 7, you can compare this to Mystic Summons, which I think work really similarly. Before I summon on Seo Yoon though, Seo Yoon, let me briefly explain what the operator recruitment is. Operator recruitment is the latest type of unit slash banner to be added to the game. These are units that are equipped as heads of the ship, pretty much. They don't attack or show up on the battlefield like the other units. Their main purpose and value lies in the passive skills and the buffs that they provide. You can see here, 30% buff to ship HP, 49.61 to ship attack, so on and so on with the command skill that, you know, does something cool. With that, let's stop talking about operators and let's get to the good stuff, huh? So, this is Seo Yoon. She is trademarked as one of the Holy Trinity in the Counterside community because she's not only good at PvP, she's also good at PvE. I just want them all because I'm greedy, so let's see how it goes. Okay, okay, okay. First 10 pool coming up. I don't know how to tell from here if it's a, you know, good character. But that's a perps. That's a perps. We take it. We skip it. I got 8-10 pulls to get this character. I am hoping to God that I get her. So let's just see, man. Another purple. Just what the doctor ordered. I don't need purples. I need waifu. Let's see how it goes, though. All right. Third Deadpool. Gotta keep the hype up. I'm gonna get something good. I know it. Okay. Okay. That's gold. I got Lumi. Okay. I have a Lumi. It's something. You know, that's something. We're gonna get her. Let's keep going. This is the one. This is gold. Okay, estarossa. She's trash, but why not? Perps. All right. I'm getting scared, but we have four more pulls, so let's see how this goes. Perps. It's fine. All right. We skippity that and we go on to the next. Go next. Three more chances. To be honest, I know when I'm going to get her because there's a little spoiler freaking thing that appears that says, hey, you completed the mission to get her. But so this isn't the one, but this is something. Oh, King Seo Yoon. I tried to get her for such a long time and like the free way to get her, and it took me a while. Yes, I have a skin for her. Okay, two more chances. It's fine. We win these. Okay, one more chance, I think, and we win these. We skip those. All right, okay. Just give me one second. Seo Yoon. Listen, all the waifus and the husbandos have passed. They don't compare to a girl with floating rifles. I mean, come on, look at you, babe. I'm gonna drop everything for you, man. Come on. Come home, please. Oh, no. No, Elizabeth. No, Elizabeth. Okay, I don't think we have anything left. We have one. This is rigged for dramatic effect, guys. I mean, isn't it obvious? Like, come on. This is the one. That's not the one. That's shit. Yeah, okay, so those were good summons, and I'm going to cry. Now let's talk a bit about my impression of the game. I've been playing Counterside, I admit, super casually as of late, since it came out around May. I was really hardcore into it when it first came out, but now my attention honestly is a bit divided and I'm playing a bunch of different games. But I do really, really, really like Counterside, and I continue to log on just to hang out and do some PvP and build some units, and I do every event that comes out. One thing to note that I didn't talk about in this video at all is that the story and localization of Counterside is freakishly good. Like, probably the best gacha game translation that I've ever seen, and they go a long way to really make it happen that way, and there's such a nice, nice quality that comes with everything that they do in terms of the writing. Also, every event has a story attached to it that always adds new dimension and information to the world. You know, they talk about the factions within the world and give more depth to the characters. Sadly, I don't think it's my main game anymore, but I'm not dropping Counterside, and I will upload additional pulls and content as it comes. I really do think this is one of the best releases of the year, absolutely. With that, thanks to everyone for watching this video. I hate to do this, but a play has got to play, so if you liked the video, please consider liking, commenting, and subscribing. As you can see, I'm a super new channel, and so I really appreciate all the help I can get. I also plan to stream on Twitch, so please consider following me over there. And if you've got a Discord, I'm looking to build a really nice community of people who like anime, games, and gacha. So please consider joining the Discord via the description below. Appreciate y'all staying towards the end, and as always, see you later, jabronis. Peace.